too bad for a couple hours of fishing out on Devil's Lake, and we threw the big walleyes back in. And I'll tell you something, Dave, I've never seen anybody clean pike as fast as you can and as efficiently as you can.
Yeah, I try to be efficient and not waste any meat. You know, I think I said it before, if you're gonna harvest an animal, whether it's a bird or a deer or a fish, I just...
Utilize it, right?
Utilize it. It deserves the respect to take what you can.
I love to hear that.
And so I do the best I can to get the most meat off the fish that I can, and I just think that's fair.
No arguments there.
Yeah.
Tell you that.
Yeah.
No waste.
Yep.
Let's see how fast you can whiz one of these northerns up. Wanna do the walleye first or no, man?
Yeah, well, yeah, I'll start with a northern.
Okay. Now watch how he does this.
So yeah, so I start off with, I take this bottom fin off just to get it out of the way. I don't have to worry about cutting around it, and then I can cut down this belly. Don't have to carve around anything now. I just
look at that.
Slab it off. What it does is it allows me to keep my blade down and my back of my knife up to ride the bones. And now this side, when I do this side, it allows me to keep the back of my knife down and my blade up just to make sure that I'm getting all the way down to the bones and not wasting any
meat. Look at that. There's no waste on that.
There's no waste. No waste.
And that's an American knife, right?
American angler. Yep. And this is called the shark blade. So now I just take and cut the ribs off. Looks like I missed a little part right here. So now,
this is the interesting part right here.
So now I take these Y bones out. You got the lateral line, and you can see all these bones sticking up, and that's the part that sticks in the air. The rest lay flat inside the middle of the fillet here. So I'm gonna come across the top of them and go just down to the bones. And I'm all the way down to the bones. Now I lay my knife. I lay it flat and right over the top of these bones. And you don't have to cut all the way through because the bones stop.
Right.
And you can see all these white lines, all the bones there.
These are all the bones right
here.
Yep.
So now I'm just gonna come back towards where the end of the ribs were. And I'm just gonna come underneath.
Look at that.
Come underneath these bones. Come back up. And this is it. I mean, you can just about see through it. There's really no waste.
And that's the part that I like to pickle.
That's what I was gonna say.
Right.
You know, it's a little skinny strip, but when you pickle them, you can't tell the bones are in there because the salt and vinegar or whatever just eats them bones right up.
Dissolves it, right?
Yeah, so, you know, if you want, instead of throwing this away, which most people do, you can keep this and utilize it and pickle it. Pickled pike is delicious.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So, you know, there's all the bones. This is bone free.
Now watch it. It'll be one solid fillet when he gets done with it. And not this, the five pieces like you normally have.
This keeps it at one piece, and the North Dakota regulation states it has to be one piece because they'll consider each piece of meat
a fish.
A fillet.
Okay.
So now this way, it's all
together.
It's all together. It's one piece of meat.
And tell everybody, I know this, but tell everybody why that meat looks so orange.
We think it has a lot to do with eating all the shrimp in this lake. These pike, especially the younger pike like these ones, they seem to take on the color because they eat a lot of shrimp. So it's gotta be the beta carotene in the shrimp.
Right.
As these fish get older, what we've noticed, once they get to be that 6 or 8 pounds, they start to lose some of this orangish color. And we think that's because they're not getting enough nutrients and getting what they need out of that shrimp diet.
Okay.
So they start to eat more fish.
Okay.
And as they put more fish in their diet, they start to lose this color.
That would make all the sense in the world.
But it seems to be that the shrimp is what gives it such that sweet taste. Because you will tell the difference between a 4 pound pike and a 10 pound pike in flavor. These 4 pounders just seem to be so sweet compared to the 10 pounders.
Because of the shrimp, you think?
Right? I believe it's because of these shrimp. You know,
right.
It's different. It's just like, you know, like going up to Lake of the Woods where where they eat so many of them shiners. I mean, those fish have a taste of their own just because of the forage they're eating.
Right.
And I think they're delicious with all the shiners they eat up there. And here, I think the pike is the better tasting fish.
Of the two, huh?
That comes out of these waters, yeah. I would rather eat the pike before the perch and the walleyes myself.
Right, I wouldn't argue that point.
It's real
bit.
Firm, it's real sweet, it's got good texture. And I just think they're great eating fish. So, you know, here we go again.
Look at that.
It's all
That's a work of art there, I'm gonna tell you.
Yeah, one piece of meat.